3-year-old Paulie Marshall and his family are giving a big thank you to the Anne Arundel County Police Department. They got him safely back with his family after a scary situation. Paulie left his house in the middle of the night last week and wandered off.
I really wanted to thank them for all their work and, you know, taking care of Paulie. Paulie's been talking nonstop about how much fun he had with the officers and the donuts and the Lunchables. It sounded like he had a little too much fun. I hope that he's not encouraged to make a break for it again.
Mom Kristen had fallen asleep on the couch instead of in bed. She thinks Paulie woke up around 3 a.m. and couldn't find her. Police say he unlocked the front door of his home on Kingbrook Road in Linthicum and started walking toward his grandparents' house. He made it nearly a mile, crossing busy streets before reaching the intersection of West Maple and Sweetser Road. That's where a passerby saw Paulie walking alone, pulled over and called police. And just in time, Paulie was walking toward those railroad tracks.
Got him and, you know, asked him, you know, what's the matter, buddy? Where do you live? And all he could do was just point up the road.
Luckily, Andy Hoffman is a trained firefighter paramedic from Baltimore City. Police officers arrived a few minutes later. All Paulie could tell them was his last name, so police started investigating.
Lieutenant started a 911 reverse call. We started door-to-door canvassing. Every time we saw someone driving or jogging, we'd stop them. Then the dispatcher, she took it a step further and did her own little investigation, and that's what ultimately led us to Paulie's old house and then to his new house.
The family is temporarily living in a rental house while the house they own is under repair. It was a neighbor at their permanent residence who identified Paulie and called his dad at work. Mom Kristen didn't know Paulie was missing. She was still sleeping when police rang her doorbell to return Paulie. She says she cried with relief, and the entire family is grateful to everyone who helped Paulie get home safely.
And if not for, you know, Andy Hoffman and the policemen and women, you know, who helped our son that night, it would be a different story we'd be telling right now, one that I don't even want to think about.
In Linthicum, Kim Dacey, WBAL-TV 11 News.